Okay. Yes, dear friends. This is the last part of the video. I will show you some photos. I want to give some important information about this grain loading, the some problems with the grain loading. Şimdi first of all this one. Here. So you see, in one of the vessel we load maize cargo, but you see it is contaminated with wheat, some small smoke here. You see these are maize, but here wheat. Also the next photo, you see some wheat mixed with maize, corn cargo. So what was the problem? Just before arrived the berth. In the silo or in the loader, previously before us they load one of the vessel with this wheat, okay, and then they start our vessel load with the corn, and then in this loader or the conveyor in the last part of the silo it is mixed. So you know, in the beginning when they start loading, it is very dusty. You cannot see anything with this one. And then we go to discharging in Spain. So we start discharging anyway. Yani 2 days, 3 days. Okay, nobody tell anything. But in the last day, they come from the port and. They told us, yeah, I don't remember the exact quantity, but it was about 43,000. Okay, we were discharging 43,000 maize cargo, corn cargo, but they told us it is about 1,000 one, yes, about 1,000 ton. It was maize, the wheat cargo, contaminated the original cargo. So what I mean? You know, this loading, the initial period is very dusty. And then you cannot understand something like this. So, before any loading port, inform captain, also inform company, also the charterer. Just tell them, please ask the port before us if they load any different cargo with the same loader, any previous vessel. So we don't want any cargo contamination or any problem. Inform them, because during loading physically you cannot understand anything. So after each loading step, even if you go, it is very, you see it is 43,000, only 1,000. And how we understand that problem? Because only in one hold, not all the holds. For example, we were loading 5 hold. Only in one hold, the first hold, the first loading hold, the initial hold, the cargo contaminated with the previous cargo. So you can inform them. Okay, so not to face that kind of problems. Actually, after discharging, they just inform us. They just only procedure, give us some protest letter, but you know, this wheat cargo much more expensive from that corn cargo. So they didn't tell anything, no problem. But if it was opposite, it will be a big problem. Okay, and then you see it's too much contaminated. And then another thing I want to tell you, if you are loading grain, especially corn, you know, in the new generation bulk carrier vessels, for example, 5-hold bulk carrier vessel, topside 1, 2, 3, port starboard, they make a ballast tank, and topside 4 and 5, port starboard, they make fuel oil tank. So, naturally, the engineers heat the fuel oil to take more fuel oil from the tank, easily take. So what is the problem here? If they heat too much, more than 55 Celsius degree, you will damage the corn cargo. Okay, it is very, very important. One of the company, When I was working in one of the vessels, that problem happened. They load and they go to discharging in Vietnam. And then during the voyage, engineers heat the fuel oil tanks too much, more than 55 Celsius degree, and they just damage the corn cargo. This corn cargo turning to black color, like this, like this. But not small, all everywhere, too much black. So it was a very big problem. So and then our company may broadcast a circular about that one. During navigation, not more than 55 degree. But what I recommend you, it is better to keep 45 and 50 degree. Because you know this, until October 2020, I think. The new fuel oil regulation already in use. So the viscosity already same like with the diesel oil. The fuel is not thick, same like in the past. It is very thin. So no need to heat too much, same like diesel oil. So keep the temperature if you load corn cargo. Also, what was the name? Soybean cargo. The temperature sensitive grain cargos. During loading, before loading, please speak engineers, chief engineer, and tell them not to heat the cargo. Keep the, if they need to heat, maximum 55-0. Yani keep the temperature maybe between 45 and 50. Not more than 50. Okay, it is very very important. Otherwise you will damage the cargo. Okay. And then another important thing. When they are discharging, you know, this is very poor practice. They grab or they load this funnel too much. Where is it? Any photo? I show you. Pardon. I just arrange like this. Pardon. You see, this is funnel loading. This is truck coming from funnel. They load the funnel too much, or they cannot adjust very good. Or their grab have too much leakage. But this is not grab leakage. This is from the funnel. They overload the damper of the truck and then it is going out. It is overflowing. Okay. So too much cargo on the pier. And then. Pardon. They sweep the cargo on the shore. Pardon. With bobcats. Okay, here and they just drop the cargo to sea. Also, be careful about this one. If something like this, you just take photo because they put the bobcat here with the bobcat. When they push the cargo, half of the cargo going to sea. It is not a good practice. Okay. And then the birds. We were in Algeria. You know, every grain pier, every grain port, always birds. We have, but in that port, Algeria, which was, what was the Annaba? I think Annaba. I don't remember exact name. I don't remember the name of the port, but there were some birds more than normal, extremely everywhere, covered with the birds. Okay, and the discharging takes about 5 days. And then during this 5 days, and what was the discharging? 4 pour, something like this. 3, 4 pour, 4 pour. So, all the birds eating your cargo. Maybe one bird eat 1 kg in 1 day. Maybe 1 million bird here. Too much thing, too much cargo they are eating. Maybe in the 5 day, maybe they eat 10 ton. Maybe more than 10 ton cargo. Okay. Also, if something like this, take photo. also, give protest letter about the cargo shortage. Okay. If the birds are more than normal. Okay. Too much birds in the beginning. Okay. This is the photos. Another thing I want to show. You know, I always speak about the loading sequence calculation about the grain cargo, but also it is important discharging sequence. Why it is important? You know, when you are loading your discharging your hold, cargo hold, your cargo hold like this, correct? This is topside, this is DBT hopper. Okay. The first steps. And then I draw also, this is from the forward direction, this is from the side. Correct, this is my cargo hold, like this. For example, here is aft, here is forward. My cargo, correct, pardon, like this. And some small gap here, correct. And also here, here. So when they discharge my cargo, easy, easy. When here is opened, okay, the forward and aft cross deck area, under deck area, open like this. So, the initial step, okay, for example, if your vessel is 5-volt vessel, so, first 5 step, you will adjust like this. How? Just enough reach 1 man. For example, first pour, you discharge, for example, hold number 1. Your cargo become like this, correct. This area open it, correct. This under deck area here open. You will just send but daytime. And then this sequence finish, okay, they go to other hold. When they are discharging in the other hold, this hold no operation, correct. You send one man with the air hose just underside of this area, the frame, just clean with the air. Okay, very very important. And then if you not clean like this, and then too much cargo stuck up here during washing, it is very very difficult to drop the cargo. And then even if some rust, some previous cargo, okay, this guy take also one garbage bag, also if any rust, paint flake, something, also some dirty cargo, something, okay, just collect the inside the bag. But anyway, with the air, just very quickly, 15 minute one side, for example, aft in 15 minute, forward aft, forward in 15 minute, total half an hour, you can clean that area. If you clean this under deck area, other remaining area during hull washing is very, very simple. Every chief officer know this one. Most difficult part is cleaning that area, that frame area in the cross deck. So, what I recommend you, when you are discharging hold number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. When you make like this, okay. For example, go to discharge hold number 3. Okay. One guy go to clean forward and up. Okay. Here finish becoming like this. Okay. Go to, for example, number 5. Okay. One guy here in half an hour forward up all the underside area with the air quickly, just quickly finish. When finish this one, okay. Forward up, aft. Okay, this one and this one finish. Okay, all forward, aft, cross deck area, under deck of which cargo hold. Just finish and then okay, it is up to you how you discharge, discharge. This is very very important, and during hold cleaning it will be very easy cleaning and very fast cleaning, because you will not spend time for reach the water with the high pressure jet, connect the hose, something, too much thing, too much headache. Okay, clean it or not clean it, able to clean, forget. This is very very good seamanship actually. I were always making like this. Not only consider loading sequence, also consider discharging sequence also. Okay, this is also another thing. Okay, so I want to show you another thing about the any Brazil, yes. No, not this one. Yes, this one. I want to show you, okay. This is before this, after loading, bak. This is, where is hold number 5? Hold number 5, this one. You see, cargo level. Okay. Like you see here, here, when we close the hatch cover, hatch cover underside touch the cargo. You see, it is inevitable. Nothing to do for this one. Okay. And then, you see the cargo level. This is before loading. Okay, I not close this one. And then, Şey, this is after loading. And then I come before discharging. One month later. Okay, one month later navigation. Okay. See cargo level going down. Here. The dust marks. Cargo easy easy going down. You see because of the vibration. Okay, it is very important. Because of the vibration, this grain cargo easy go down. Okay. So as much as possible, as much as possible. Bak, you see here cargo easy go down. Because of the vibration cargo settle down. Okay, settle down the cargo. Don't forget grain cargo always like this, especially small piece cargo. Maybe the corn not too much like this, but especially the wheat and the barley, something small piece cargo settle down too much. Okay, you see here too much go down, and this is what, where is it, pardon, yes, this is the after discharging, very very high, you see much more high. And one of the another important thing I want to show you. For example, we just easy easy go from the photos. You see. This is old number two. But you see, this is Australian loading. Actually, they are loading very very good. Very good, my friend. Very good. Very systematic. And you see the level of the cargo. Almost hatch coming. And also for the Australian regulations, if this here, if your cargo, if this distance from the hatch coming distance, this one, you see this distance more than 10 centimeter, they assume your cargo hold is slack. And then that is why their operator are very good. But what I want to tell you, even if in the other country or in Australia, not important. As a chief officer, always you finalize the cargo hold. Don't forget. Always you. In the final step, you go. Okay, for example, this hold now become a final step. They will fill only the middle and then the surface. So in when become like this, that step for completing the cargo hold as a chief officer, in the last part, you must be on the deck. And then second thing, speak with the foreman. Tell them, final step, I went foreman on board. Okay. And you just take one laser pointer. You see, here is one guy. You see this orange color here. This is remote control. There is no operator on the top. Okay. So he can see the level of the cargo easily from deck. But sometimes in some countries, the operator cabin here. So they look the cargo hold in up and down condition, vertical condition, so he cannot easily understand the level of the cargo. Okay, in that case you just stay here with laser pointer. Okay, show them, fill here, fill here, fill here, where is empty. Okay, this is also important thing. But if they are on deck, no problem. But anyway, just stay with them, not disturb them too much. Even if they hear, not disturb them too much. But you see, I want to show here another, for example, this is Australian loading, but in previous, you see the loading method here. You see what? They are coming like this, like this, like this, like this. For example, with the laser pointer, you just tell them, okay, fill here, and then here, and then here, and then here. They cannot make like this. They just go like S, okay. Just like this. So that is why you have to adjust those. Okay, you tell them start from here, easy easy go to that side. So one direction they can go. The loader one time here and then suddenly here and then suddenly here, they cannot make operation like this. So the best way actually I have ever seen is the Australian loading method, my friend. Why? Because this is very very systematic. Okay, the calculation. Okay, what I want to tell you, when you go to Australia for the grain loading, calculation is headache. Okay, I understand this one, but when they accept, the calculation as per rules, as per Grignard. And when you make the sequence, really it is very very easy because they are very very professional. Okay, they really the most easy loading in the world is the Australian grain loading. You just speak with them, give them the what was the name, the loading sequence plan, and then in the final step, one by one, you just go. Very very simple because they are loading very systematic, my friend. They just complete here and then the center. You see, very professional method. Also, I load coal cargo. They load always same method. Okay. One side, other side, one side, other side, one side. They make V in the middle and then complete the pull. Very good systematic. If you go any port and if they have some problem with the loading, so you can also advise them that method. Okay, this is forward, this is aft. Just make V, finalize, fill the pull instead of going like this, like this, like this, like this. Okay, and then. Yeah, the belt cargo, something I have already told before. I am not talking about again. You see, very very good loading, my friend, and not too much spillage on the corners. You see, nothing, just nothing, very good. But speak with them what you want in the final experienced foreman. You speak with them. Okay, you tell them I will come on deck. Not in Australia, everywhere. When you are making grain loading, the last part of the loading. Tell them I will come on board as a chief officer with the laser pointer. Okay, just feel here, feel here, something. But I want the foreman on board and experienced operator for the final part. You see, this is almost level. Okay, we go another. For example, Brazilian loading. Pardon. For example, you see, yani it is not same actually. Pardon. You see some gaps. Yeah, these are also good. You see, as much as possible, they make good loading. But you see, too much spillage on the hatch coming, the railings, the compression bar area. You see, some spillage on deck, something. Okay, as much as possible, don't forget. You see, the sides are empty. There are no feeder hole here. This is the, for example, port side, not the forward or aft. So actually, the best is the Australia ISO until today. You see this area empty. So you just speak with them, okay, and stay on board, okay. And then also don't forget the cargo settle down, cargo. Wet, what was the name, the contamination with the other cargo, the birds, the cleaning steps. Okay, the spillage on deck, spillage on shore, spillage on deck. If too much, you cannot load to cargo hold again. So too much spillage, it will affect your draft survey, maybe 3 ton, 5 ton, something. If too much, if too much, also important. Okay. Another thing I want to show you, the closing the hatch cover, anything, nothing here. Okay, same. And then we just proceed. Brazil. Any big photo, I just make them bigger. Yes. You see here, this is fumigation. Okay. They put the fumigation inside the socks and then you see they just lay the socks here. Don't forget this socks, this fumigation medicine. Okay, if put some tin when discharging port, another tin to come take this one. Okay, this is not ship's business actually. Generally, charterers always ask vessel collect this one. Actually, this is not for the ship's business. Also, what is the danger here? Some type of this medicine you collect, you put in barrel and you put the barrel into the store. When they contact with the air, okay, They start burning. This is also important thing. If even if, okay, in somehow if you collect the fumigation medicine, just leave the barrel on deck. So if it starts burning, you will see. And preferably not plastic barrel, metal barrel. Okay, it is very very important. You collect, put in the deck store. Okay, maybe you will have fire on board. Don't forget this one. But normally this is charterer business. Okay, before arrival, just send charterer some message. What is your plan about the fumigation? You see, our crew collecting. We were collecting this one because they were refusing. They just give us some mask anyway. But this is not a good practice actually. Anyway. Even if you collect, don't forget. Put them, all of them, in metal barrel and keep the metal barrel on deck. Not on the deck store. Okay. Maybe it can fire. Okay. Another photo do we have? I show. I want to show. Nothing. Okay. We just... What is this? Yeah, this is always same. Okay. Gel abi şuradan. Fransa. Yes. I want to show something. Another important thing. Şimdi we load in France. Rouen. Grain cargo. And we were going to discharge in Algeria. Okay. You see, this is not same good as good as Australian loading, but anyway, they were loading good. But you see some small peaks here. Okay. What is important here? I have already explained before. Some small gaps. Okay. But you just open close your hatch cover first. Just make sure your rubber packing of the hatch cover touching the compression bar here. Properly closing. If any problem, okay, with these some wooden sweepers, you just adjust. Another thing, bak, I want to show here. Şimdi after loading demişiz. This one. This is after discharging in Algeria. What happened, my friend? Şimdi in hold number 5. When we start loading, my first hold were hold number 5, okay. And then we come to artık end of the cargo. So we just see here some black cargo. Oh, everybody come to vessel. İşte too much problem, big problem. You just make the cargo wet. Maybe some fuel oil go. Where is your fuel oil tanks? What happened? So when we clean the around of that black part of the cargo. Okay. We just understand the problem. Okay. You see everywhere is clean. Only in the center of the cargo hold some black cargo. What happened? Before we arrival to Rouen, the weather was rainy. And then some of the cargo on the loading belt becoming wet. Okay. They just turn this one, but maybe in the first part of the loading, the loader, some small, very small cargo. Okay, this is maybe half barrel cargo. Black color, it becoming wet. So when they run the loader belt with the initial cargo, just very small drop here. Because of the dust, we cannot see anything. So just very small half barrel cargo, wet cargo drop in the first hold. And then remaining we already load here. So you see, and then when we come to discharging, so the here bobcat, when sweeping the cargo on the top of the cargo hold, suddenly hit this one and spread this black color dirty cargo. If he didn't, operator didn't spread, it was just very small half barrel something. But when he push, hit suddenly, okay, spill everywhere. So when you look, it seems like very big area. Actually very very small. So also consider this. Speak with the foreman. Before loading, did you run your loader belt, conveyor system empty? And You tell them in some of the vessel experience that kind of problem. The initial cargo, if coming wet, will be problem. Okay, this is also important thing because when they start loading, it is coming dusty. When hit the tank top, you cannot see anything because of the dust. This is also another important thing. So, for that loading, grain loading, two things you have to speak. First, please clean your belt properly. I don't want black color cargo. Second, what did you load before? For example, we are loading now wheat cargo, but you previously load, for example, corn cargo. I don't want cargo contamination. Please clean your belts properly. Okay, same like here, cargo contamination. I don't want that problem. Okay. My cargo, for example, corn, but your previous cargo is wheat. I don't want any mix. Okay, this is also important thing. You also advise the charter, also the company. Because when they start, they start. So because of the dust, you cannot see anything. Also same like here. Okay. Top of the cargo hold, how will you see? Just very very small thing initially coming and then covering with the clean cargo. This is also another important thing. Okay, so my friend, this is here. Yes, you see they just load some small peaks of the cargo. You open close your hatch cover. If any contact area, same like here, for example. Nerede? Şurası herhalde. You see, when you close your hatch cover, underside of hatch cover will touch the peaks. If higher than the hatch coming, you see here. This area, you see, yes. So close your hatch cover, make sure it's your rubber packing touching the compressions bar properly, and then open again. If any touch, okay, you just enter cargo hold. But this must be very very little normally, you know. Yes. I drop this one also. Where is the pin photo? With this wooden sweepers, you just very little trimming, very very little. This must be very little. You see, my hatch cover underside is flat. I draw again. For example, this is my hatch coming, like this. Okay, and when I close my hatch cover, to top of it, from the half, here the wheel, here the wheel. If my hatch cover, I close this one. Huh. If my hatch cover underside is flat, okay, no problem. But you know, some of the hatch covers underside going like this. So, it will be another problem. Huh. How many centimeter? For example, this is 20 centimeter. Okay, so in that case, where is the photo? Not like this, because this is flat. It must start from the 20 centimeter down. Okay, this is also another. So, otherwise, if you fill until the hatch cover, when you close, if the underside, because sometimes they make strange frames like this going, okay, like this, it is going down and then going. So this height, sometimes about 20 centimeters something, you will not able to close the hatch cover. It will be very very big problem. Okay, so that is all I want to tell. Okay, with the next videos, I will make the explanation of Korean booklets. Also, I will make an example calculation with the USA grain loading manual. Okay, the National Cargo Bureau form, grain loading form. Okay, example calculation I will make with the next video series. My friends, each Monday or Tuesday, I am planning to make videos and regularly, okay, because previously I were not able to make. sometimes 1 month pass, sometimes 2-3 months, mate, pass. So I want to make it in a schedule. In every week I will start making videos. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Okay. Thank you very much. See you.